Welcome to the Short Book Summaries channel. Enjoy and subscribe if you like our work. Alain de Botton combines two unlikely genres, literary biography and self-help manual, in the hilarious and unexpectedly practical How Proust Can Change Your Life. Who would have thought that Marcel Proust, one of the most important writers of our century, could provide us with such a rich source of insight into how best to live life? Proust understood that the essence and value of life was the sum of its everyday parts. As relevant today as they were at the turn of the century, Proust's life and work are transformed here into a no-nonsense guide to, among other things, enjoying your vacation, reviving a relationship, achieving original and uncliched articulation, being a good host, recognizing love, and understanding why you should never sleep with someone on a first date. It took de Botton to find the inspirational in Proust's essays, letters and fiction and, perhaps even more surprising, to draw out a vivid and clarifying portrait of the master from between the lines of his work. Here is Proust as we have never seen or read him before, witty, intelligent, pragmatic. He might well change your life. My wife and I fell in love reading this book together, way back in September/October 2002. I don't know what anyone else will think of this book, but I'll never enjoy reading a book more. B and I left a note on Proust's grave when we visited Paris on our honeymoon. He is the, gay, patron saint of our marital union. Here's my best advice, read this book with a loved one. Proust said the great moments, like when he ate the Madeleine dipped in tea, are those when we escape time. We do what we do in the present, but we experience the same action in the past. Thus we are nowhere, neither in past nor present. The miracle of an analogy has freed us from the lockstep of time. He does not explain why this freedom should be so desirable, but presumably it is because time moves in only one direction, toward weakness and death. We embrace the things that allow us to transcend death: artists' art, monks' God, some people sex, some people television. Peanut 159.